Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Cordant. We're back to continue our playthrough of Pillars of Eternity with the Triple Crown difficulty settings. We are currently in Stalwart, once again, for the quest The Recluse of the White March. We're looking for a direct soul descendant from someone from Durgan's battery. So, we found one lady already. I'm guessing there's more people. I'm just trying to look around and look for the people with names to see if they have any kind of relation to this quest. So we're gonna continue here. Let's see if these guys... Okay, so read Andret's soul. A handful of memories dart across your mind like startled fish, leaving indistinct images and sounds in their wake. For a moment, you are overwhelmed, until one particular recollection tugs at your senses with stubborn force. You, or Andret, or both, kneel on a stone floor held between two men. The man pacing in front of you wears the armor of a crucible knight, and you feel Andret's half-hearted contempt for him as if it were your own. You feel Andret's triumph too when the knight comes just close enough for you to spit blood onto his boots. The memory slips away from you and you find yourself back in your own shoes. Okay, so nothing from this guy. Read Berthoen's soul. The whiff of salt and brine is in your nostrils before the room has even faded. The group heaves beneath your feet, or the ground, sorry, and the spray of ocean water roars over the railing as the ship heels under the wind. The ship shudders violently, and you are thrown against the railing. In that moment, you find your gaze pulled to the pitching surface of the dark sea, and see there an eye, broad as a shield, gazing back at you in turn. Fear and fascination sweep through your mind, even as your senses recede and the memory fades.
Thanks again. I'll be gone just as soon as the weather clears.
This lady doesn't have an interaction. I don't think the bard is interactable, but let's just see.
Hey.
No. Villagers, somebody in the rooms, villagers... Oh, Owina, a named character.
What is it?
Oh, this one had a nice green glow.
Something I can do for you? Halfrick's got me straightening the rooms, but I'll help you if I can.
Well, let's read the soul. You feel for Owina's essence and almost instantly find yourself wrapped in darkness. It takes you a moment to realize that you've plunged into a very old memory. But as your eyes adjust to the torchlight, you find yourself standing in a gloomy tunnel that you instinctively recognize as part of Durgan's battery. Ah. A handful of figures in patchy cloaks and hoods, dwarves like you, hunch over a minecart. They're loading it with cloth-wrapped bundles from which you see the occasional flash of metal. The edge of a blade or the burnished glow of plate. The other dwarves scurry with a curious mixture of haste and caution. They stack the bundles in a din of muted clangs and thumps, following the echoes of their ruckus down the tunnel with nervous eyes.
Pay attention! Sooner we get this done, sooner we can go.
Your voice is a dry whisper, and your nerves tingle with energy. You feel the same apprehension that the others do, but unlike them, you relish it. Still, you look over your shoulder, just in case.
We're hurrying, Captain Gregor. Honest.
Captain Gregor, okay. When you turn back, the others have redoubled their efforts and you feel a pleasurable twist in your gut as they fill the cart. Being captain of the guard doesn't pay much, but it does allow you to visit the armory without raising eyebrows. And with Coin Master Zoltan selling off half of the battery's arsenal, who's going to notice a few more missing pieces? Oh, so he was stealing. Besides, you've got a buyer lined up. As long as you can move these goods out of the battery before someone squeals. You pull back from the memory to find Owina staring at you.
Sir? Excuse me, sir. You alright?
Her head is cocked and her brow is furrowed. So, this one didn't mention anything regarding danger or power, but it is a captain of the guard, so it should know the cantec to enter Durgan's battery. And I think we're gonna go with this one. Because if I remember correctly, well, my memory isn't the best, but I think there's only two souls to choose from. And it's either this one or the other one. So I'm gonna go with this one, which is less dangerous. Awaken, Gregor, and remember your theft from the armory.
Who? I don't...
Her face goes slack, and she looks for a second as if she's fallen asleep. But her eyelids flutter, and after several seconds, they open to slits.
Thief? I'm the captain of the guard. Best be careful where you sling an accusation like that.
Her words are slow and calculated. Relax, Gregor. I was hoping we could work together.
We're of one mind, then. However, I like to see offers on the table before I deal. What would you give me?
I awakened you. Seems you owe me now.
I see.
Her expression flickers, but she otherwise hides her surprise.
You have me at a loss, and yet this is not a loss entirely.
She looks herself over, holding out her arms and feeling the fabric of her clothing. I need to reach Durgan's battery. The cantec, please.
Hammers of Durgan, ring loud. May the anvil's deep music resound. Walls of the battery safeguard our works from marauder and wilder alike. Abidun's faithful travail by the forge, and the fires that brighten the ore.
That's a lot of thing to say to open a door.
If anyone asks, you didn't hear it from me. Got that? Now.
Owina doubles over, sneezing hard enough to scatter dust across the floor. She looks back up at you, wiping at her watery eyes.
Beg your pardon for going on so. I got carried away and...
She stops, blinking.
What was that I said? About hammers and fires and...
Her eyes grow wide and round, so I could either just try to leave and leave her in the dark for this, but I'm just gonna be honest and tell her that you're awakened. You share the soul of a guard captain from Durgan's battery.
You must be joking. How could that happen?
I awakened you. This is the honest answer. His soul reincarnated whole within you. Sometimes awakenings result. I'm gonna keep with my personality of being honest. I will just tell her I awakened you. I need information about the battery.
I can't be awakened. That means...
She takes a step back, covering her mouth with her hands.
Ponderous tides, I'm stuck with him.
Her body goes rigid, every muscle tensing. She stands there, frozen in shock. Until a sly look warms her eyes. The thaw creeps down her shoulders and torso until at last she speaks again. Her voice is smooth as oil.
It's not all bad, Owina. Way I see it, you and me can make some deals. To our mutual benefit.
Oh God. She cranes her neck, taking in the dark room.
Deals? What do you want from me? For you, not from you. I'm thinking it's time we got a raise. I don't know about that. Hafrick's a bit of a miser, he is.
Owinus's anxious frown replaces Gregor's confident smirk.
Don't you worry about Hafrick. I've got something else in mind.
Oh, my lord. Owina falls into a look of deep contemplation as she and Gregor continue in silent conference. Well, this was the choice. And now I'm going to tell you guys something that I also know about this quest. And this is something that I investigated some time back, which is, out of these two souls, the best one to awaken, best in terms of the best possible outcome, is actually the other one, the powerful and dangerous one. And the reason for it being that with that soul, you can actually push it back down. So you can awaken her and then you can push down the soul again. But you need to have a lot of nice scores for that. So I think you need to have lore, I think you need to have constitution, something like that, stuff that my main character actually does not have. So it wouldn't really make much of a difference. But the point here is that if you go with Tena, the best possible outcome is that you push the soul back down and then you get an extra cache of... Durgan's steel in Durgan's battery. That's kind of the bonus there. I don't think I have anything else to do here. So Durgan's battery, I know the cantec. I'm gonna go back to Galvino. But not here. Just to see if that is something that he might want to say regarding, you know, the quests we've just made and all that stuff. But I think I want to do something before I go into Durgan's battery. Because this is the main area, and I think it's also the longest area of this White March expansion. So I think I want to get into some danger before I go there. Which hopefully will not bite me back in the butt. But I'm talking about that cave that my spider senses were tingling about. I think I'm gonna go there today. I feel fairly confident. I don't remember how different that fight is from other quote-unquote similar ones. I'm not entirely... I'm speaking vaguely because I don't want to spoil it for anybody that might not know what lies in that cave. But yeah. So, Galvino.
The devil has not scorched you yet, eh? Perfetto.
Perfetto. I have news about Grinde.
Yes? Does the sniveling cur hide in his home? Or has he been exiled to a place even more frigid and foul?
He claps his hands together in excitement. I learned that he murdered his sister.
Tiverus! The man is even more of a wretch than I thought!
His face glows with macabre delight.
What of him now? Surely the villagers string him up with his own fishing line.
I decided not to shame it after all.
Matico! I should have known better than to ask a milksop.
Careful.
Go. I need to collect myself.
He turns away from you, fuming.
The devil has not scorched you yet, eh?
He's fine again. He turns away from you fuming, but he's fine. I don't really think there is much of a different outcome from that quest. Maybe he gives you something, maybe he doesn't if you shame the other guy. Don't actually know. I'm pretty sure I shamed the guy when I played with my evil priest for my evil playthrough. But I don't remember what happened. So yeah, are you guys ready for some danger? That's the best way for me to put it. Danger. I hope I'm not gonna kill myself. But I think we have enough tools to do this. I mean, we have the max level spells. We have good armor pieces. We have good weapons. So I think I'm fairly safe in... Well, safe isn't the best word. But I feel confident that I have the tools at my disposal to work on this fight without it being a massacre. I'm starting to feel that nervous tingling in my chest. Okay. So this is the cave that my spider senses were tingling about. We're gonna go in. And I'm gonna use the same strategy that I used in the previous time that I did this. And if I remember right, I think I had put all of my people on this corner. And then I only sent it there in. I think that's what I did. We can have a little bit more breathing room, like this, for example.
Hey.
So now, as a little bit of a spoiler, I'm gonna equip an item here, which is gonna be this Iveras' diving helmet, to give us plus 35 defense against dragon breath attacks. So that might tell you something about this fight. We're gonna drink some white Yinfer for 3 damage reduction on everybody. Okay, get that. Now, my resting bonus does not give me intellect. So we're gonna eat some fishy with my fishy people. There you go. I am going to eat a rabbit stew for some more perception on my rogue. You have eaten that, true. And for you guys, I think I want constitution and perception. So do that. Okay, what happened to your food buffs? Oh, you can actually... I can munch everything for all of the buffs. Okay, interesting. Okay, so... we have to be careful about this. I don't want to just kill myself. So, I will be using my summons. I want to make sure that I have my summons equipped. Where is my Delamgan? Oh, it's on Aloth. I think it's going to stay on Aloth, yeah. Nobody's going to use it, but I think we're fine. Okay, so I have my food buffs. I have a potion of Landgrass Displaced Image in my inventory. You have it as well. You guys are fine. I have a flask of war paint. I have Scalebreaker. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna go like this. This is, I think, is a good position. And we will advance with Edair. And he can be unstealthed. And this is our enemy right now, the Alpine Dragon. I'm hoping this goes well. That's all I'm hoping. I'm hoping this goes well. I would love to swap my chant, but it's combat only. I want to swap for this one, which gives us buffs against beasts.
Following your lead.
I'm moving a little bit closer because he's quite far away. And let's talk to this fella. The Alpine Dragon. The dragon turns its head to look at you. Its red eyes are clouded like dirty ice, and its sides heave with labored breaths. Frosty plumes jet between its teeth.
Leave. Now.
The only sound the dragon makes is a hoarse growl. But you hear it as clearly as if it were spoken language. The beast bares its teeth. So, the cool thing about this fight, or about this encounter, is that if you just stumble into this area by accident, you get a chance to leave. You don't actually just die. But I'm gonna converse with this dragon. You look ill.
I can still peel the flesh from your bones.
The dragon coughs, spattering the ice with crimson droplets. You see something femur-shaped stuck between its teeth. What's the problem exactly?
Consider it indigestion. And consider yourself lucky I've eaten.
A belch rumbles up from the dragon's throat and reverberates in the ice under your feet. Did you eat Igadar, the young man by the road?
Was that the rodent's name? I only know that he tasted mealy and lean.
The dragon probes the leg bone with its tongue. So yeah, so that's the guy that came all that way looking for his soul twin, and he found it right here. He came looking for his soul twin. What did you have to do? What did that have to do with you?
Centuries I've lived. I won't share my soul with some mewling youth.
Wait, you're his soul twin? Why did you kill him?
While he lived, his suffering became mine. And as he drew closer, his weakness infected my essence. I can never be strong while a soul twin of mine lives.
I take it you've been through this before?
Since I was a worm, sudden fits of agony and terror would paralyze me. I was a prisoner to experiences that weren't mine.
The dragon's tail slowly coils and uncoils.
Eventually, I noticed something similar in my fellow hatchlings. I felt their cries and shrieks become mine as they nipped and flew at one another.
How did you become linked with your siblings?
I don't waste my time with the mysteries of souls, what sunders them and how the turning of the wheel apportions them. What matters is power, survival. I killed as many of the other hatchlings as I could. I felt their pain, but I also felt parts of their souls become mine.
Bitch! It slitted pupils wide with the memory.
I slaughtered and devoured, and the scent of blood drove my siblings into a frenzy. Our nest became a maelstrom of chaos as we fought, dying and feeding together. At last, only a handful of us were left. We were sickened by all we'd consumed and suffered.
The spines along its head flatten. What happened to the hatchlings that survived?
I eventually hunted down some of my missing siblings. Others returned to me in other skins and other lives, as that boy did.
I understand. Killing your soul twins was wrong. Your reasons don't change that. Something churned noisily in the dragon's stomach.
As interesting as this conversation has been, I've had enough of it.
The dragon picks at his teeth with a claw and finally pops the leg bone free. It chews on the morsel, its eyes fixed on you. Don't start a fight. I wanna fight, bitch. Try me. Yeah, try me. You're not gonna win this fight, man. I hope. Okay, so I wanna swap to this one, which hopefully is the it's the correct one. And oh, I'm not in combat yet. Okay, so now I'm in combat. So as usual, we're gonna clutter up the ground with summons. I'm gonna put my other beetle there. I'm gonna put my shades there. We are going to get our scarab figurines there. And I think that's it. I could go for the Delam gun as well. Or should I just start buffing with Ale? I'm just gonna start buffing. I think it's safer. So, the last time, trying to queue up actions didn't work properly. Let's hope that this time it does. Delta's Lacrity of Motion, Merciless Gaze, and I'm gonna go all out on defenses here because we have some time for it. So let's see if I can get this working. So Wizard's Double, Mirrored Image, Bulwark Against the Elements, Landgrat's Displaced Image, Calicot's Minor Blight. But depending on how the fight progresses, I might just put up a wall over here to make sure that no enemies can start streaming in. As for Mr. Durance, we're gonna go for the Minor Avatar, as I like doing. And then I'll see, because I think my party will start kind of shifting around based on the movements we need. And you are going to get a potion of Bulwark Against the Elements, but you're gonna do so over there. Let's slow this down, let's start moving and hope that we do not die. Okay, you go there, you go there, you go there, you go there. Shade go here, shade go there, shade go there. Okay, and like before, I'm gonna try to position the dragon so that he looks like in that direction, not over there. So go over there. I have my shades. I could go for a potion of alacrity. It lasts 30 seconds. So yeah, do that. Mm-hmm. The grieving mother has just summoned her friends. I think I'm gonna go for Delta's Lacrity of Motion from my item. My chest armor. Kana, what is Kana gonna do? What is Kana going to do? I think he's just gonna stay where he is and we're gonna wait for our buffs. Hey there, turn this on and keep moving. Where are you going? He's going for it there, but he's taking like the long way around. Maybe I can kind of distract him with the other beetle. That could work, maybe. Or if you stay right there, it should be also fine. Although, a dragon's breath might hit my party? Question mark? We'll see. Okay, so, drink your potion of bulwark against the elements. The grieving mother can start doing something right now. Which is, yeah, she's gonna buff herself, that's right. I'm drinking my potion. What was that? The Alpine Dragon already killed a bunch of stuff. With what? What killed my summons here? Windstorm. Okay. Deals freeze damage and blinds as well. Okay. We're still buffing, we're fine, we're still fine. No, you guys come back here. God damn it. So I will want Durans to come into the middle of my friends. Oh, okay, so he got critted, so the Shodin Faith boots triggered. That's what I actually wanted to do, so no longer need that. We're gonna go for Crowns for the Faithful on top of my party. And I'm gonna see if I have range to start shooting the dragon. I nearly have range because I can hit that guy, I just can't hit him. So I'm gonna try and sap him, see if that works. Okay, I hit him, but I missed with the additional effect. He has 123 deflection, that's quite a lot. And he summons specters, oh, that's not good. Okay, so, well, Kana, time to off-tank, my friend, go there. The grieving mother can start blasting these tanks, these specters. Edair is just kind of doing his thing over there. He drank his potion of protection, so that's good. Grieving Mother is shooting. I'm gonna try and set dragon again, try and buy some time. Bite him. Okay, so Crowns for the Faithful has still not gone off. Ooh, he's going for someone else. Don't know who he's going for, but I'm gonna make sure it's there. Let's charge him. I think he's trying to cast an Ice Storm, which is not good, so hopefully I can stun him. Oh my god, please don't. Okay, so we have Crowns for the Faithful. So what do I need now? I think I'm gonna go for extra defenses with a Circle of Protection, because that's always good. And after that, let me see what we have that I can use. This is a revive. Now, I'm gonna go for Devotions for the Faithful after this. The grieving mother missed everything on the specter. Really? My stun also did not work. Try and blind him. We're gonna swap what we're doing over here. We have... I still don't have the minor blights, but that's fine. I want my wall of many colors right here. When the dragon comes in, he's gonna get whatever the effect is gonna be. After this, I want Prayer Against Fear, because we're all terrified. Okay, he's still going for Edair, and Edair just charged him. I'm gonna turn him over there. Move. I said move, were you knocked prone? No, he's just dazed. Okay, so he's moving. He's over there, good. The Wall of Many Colors is up. I'm going to use my friend Mr. Aloth here to do something, which is gonna be what? I'm going to increase my accuracy, and after increasing my accuracy, I am going to toss out a Shadow Flame, try and paralyze as much as I can. over there. We have our circle of protection. My rogue... What? How does my rogue have two saps again? I'm going to consider this a bug and I will not use the saps because that doesn't make a lot of sense. The grieving mother is still working on the spectre. I guess I'm gonna start working on the spectre as well because I can't really hit this guy. And there's also a wraith. Okay, sorry, I have to think about this. Everything is fine. Okay, I petrified something with Aloth. There goes the Shadow Flame. These guys are apparently immune. The dragon was missed, I'm guessing. Crits, hits, grazes, crits... Wait, grazed? Okay, so he does not take freeze damage. But wait, he wasn't paralyzed, but he was hit by it. Strange. Okay. So, what can I do here with Mr. Aloth? I think I'm gonna start trying to debuff the dragon with the Miasma of Dull-Mindedness. And after the Miasma, I'm gonna go for the Archimedes Wondrous Torment to reduce his will. And then I'm gonna try and petrify him, I believe. Okay, the Grieving Mother actually did some damage here. I would still want some more so I could get Defensive Mind Web. How much do you heal with this? 99 endurance, so you can actually just do that now. Okay, okay. Kana is apparently stunned. That's not good. Devotions for the faithful, we're gonna get a prayer against fear. Or I could just go for an amplified wave to deal with these annoying enemies here. Okay, so... The Frost Tooth is petrified, this is petrified. This guy didn't actually run over the wall. Okay, so did the Miasma hit? The Miasma hit. That's a very good start. I'm gonna start shooting him again with my rogue. Oh, I'm dumb. Scalebreaker. And then shoot him. We have protection against fear. Archimedes Wondrous Torment hit. So it is time for us to... I still have my accuracy buff. Let's go for a Gaze of the Adragon on top of this bitch. And if it lands, I think we're gonna be in a fine position. So we're gonna debuff the dragon. Actually, I'm gonna go for a Holy Radiance to have more accuracy on everybody. And then I'm going to debuff everything over here with my friend Mr. Durance. And if I could also hit with the Hand of Will and Woe, I would start healing everybody in the area while also hurting the dragon. What's the range for this? I would have to move closer. Don't like moving closer. Don't like moving closer at all. Resurrection. I could start tossing out some fire damage as well. Yeah, sure. So aim there. And it should hit the dragon. Okay, okay. Gaze of the Adragon. Landed. Petrified for 15 seconds. Screw you, bitch. Okay, so. You are stunned for 1 second, but then I want you to hit him. And do you have Minor Blights? You actually don't have Minor Blights. So it's time for me to really damage this guy. So I'm thinking I could go for raw damage. I only have one cast of this, and the radius is how far? 7.72 meters. So this might hit it there. Wait, did I hit? Wait, sorry, give me a second here. Foe AU, are you petrified? He's not, there's just a lot of enemies petrified here. Okay, so I'm gonna go for a Wilting Wind, see how much raw damage I can do to the dragon, which is gonna be doubled. And then I'm gonna start spamming this. Minoletus is precisely piercing bursts. So 1, 2, 3. It will also hit these guys over here, which is lovely. I'm shooting him, and once he goes down to about half HP, I'm gonna start shooting off finishing blows. Let's go. He is debuffed. Oh, he's injured. Finishing blow. Finishing blow. We have 140 focus points on the Grieving Mother, because she dealt a lot of damage to the dragon. So now we can actually go for a defensive mind web, giving us all immense protections. This costs 80 focus, that means I'm gonna be left with 60 focus, which is just perfect for an amplified wave on top of it there. Let's see our wilting winds. It dealt a fair bit of damage. Let's see my finishing blow. I think I dealt 200 damage. No, only 80, what? 85. There's 191, oh, maybe this was this. Come on, man, I gotta hit for more. Oh, baby. Never mind. So there goes the finishing blow. It hadn't gone off yet. Crit for 218 pierce damage, sneak attack, death blows. Yeah. Okay, so fight's over. Screw you, dragon. This one is not immune to petrification. So that's how you deal with him. And now it's just a matter of cleaning up the fight. So we can dash over there.
Much for you.
Yeah. Okay. Happy. Happy, happy. Okay, we can just buff a little bit more. You are just doing nothing because you don't need to do anything. You can just shoot. Oh, he's dominated. Never mind. Shoot there. And it there, just go over there. Kana, you can go over there. Cordant, you can shoot that frost ooze. I keep forgetting that the amplified wave does not do damage to the ice blights. But there we go. That's how we deal with the Alpine Dragon. I will say, it wasn't the cleanest fight in the world, because I didn't remember that those specters would come in. Oh god, what is this? Oh, I think it's the souls leaving his body. Okay, Jesus. Let me just finish my thought. I did not remember that the shades and the specters would start coming in during the fight, and that kind of messed up my positioning, because that way I started getting stunned by the specters. I probably should have had a wall of many colors, something like in this position, so it would block people coming in from that side and people coming in from this side. But overall, they didn't really do much because of the amount of buffs I already had on. So the crowns for the faithful are gonna give us tremendous defenses. And Kana could also off-tank fairly decently, so that was also useful. But really, Durance just gave us so many buffs that the Spectres weren't really a problem for my party at that moment in time. Edair was tanking the dragon, and he can tank very well. His triggered immunity, I think, also played a bit of a role there, because he took a nice chunk of damage, which made him immune to that same chunk of damage. I'm talking about this, by the way. This one. I think this is actually one of the newest skills that got added to the game. But yeah, if you take damage that does at least 10% of his total endurance, he will gain immunity to that type of damage for a short duration. So for 15 seconds, he's immune to the type of damage that he just took. And the dragon hit him, so he got immune to the dragon's damage for 15 seconds. Very good. We also had our potions, which also helped. The food buffs also help. And then, I mean, Aeloth with Scalebreaker and Aeloth debuffing the dragon and then landing a petrification just seals the fight. He would never get out of that petrification. 15 seconds petrified, he's gonna die. And it only took me a single finishing blow. Well, my other people also contributed. But I only used one of my two finishing blows and we just killed him right there. It's kind of a shame that the combat log doesn't go up anymore, because I like analyzing these fights and looking over what happened and how much damage certain skills did. But regardless, I'm very happy with the outcome. That's another one of the big enemies in the game dealt with. Let me see. I usually use this one. So we're gonna go back to this one. Hey. And let's check out the loot. Or actually, before we do that, so swap back to this before I forget. I think I also completed the quest for the Soul Twins. He's better off, yes. Yagdr came to the White March searching for his Soul Twin, but somebody killed him in the Lonely Mountain Passes. I found the final wisps of his soul in the wilds east of Stalwart. I discovered that Yagdr was killed by his Soul Twin, a dragon. I slew the dragon. That's how I like it. Simple, concise. It tells the story. That's fine.
Hey.
I also had a new quest, a Wreath of Ashes, which is going to give me a minor item only, which makes me sad. In the Valley Republic of Palminia, a military graveyard has been struck by vandals that burn tributes left for the dead. Though troubling to the Duchess, she has few local resources to deal with the problem. As the Republic will soon be celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Battle of Lagon Pirella, the Duchess would like to have the mystery solved quickly and quietly. We shall assign Palagina to do this.
Hey.
For no particular reason. The Spectres? I'm gonna leave Dragon for last if I can. Okay, let's loot. So this guy, he doesn't actually have much. He only has dragon meat. He doesn't drop scales or eyes or any kind of crafting materials, which is a little bit unfortunate, to be quite honest. Does he have a dragon's horde? Let's move in stealth to detect hidden stuff. Come on. Yes.
There's something ahead.
But yeah, just to finish my thought about fighting dragons, I believe that from the point where I get crowns for the faithful, and especially once I get minor avatar, I think that's where I feel the safest when fighting these dragons. You don't really even need these level 8 spells. Naturally, on Aloth, they do help. The Wall of Many Colors can be very helpful to keep, you know, the other tiny enemies from start streaming in on top of your party. This one, sure, it helped, but the main spells here were level 6. It's the Gaze of the Adragan, the Precisely Piercing Burst for the burst damage, the Miasma of Dull-Mindedness, Eldritch Aim. That's the kind of thing. Archimedes' Wondrous Torment to debuff his intellect further. These are the important spells, all the way up to here. I didn't even use any kind of level 7 spell. There's no need. Once you get level 6, I think you're ready to fight dragons. Level 7 is better because of minor avatar. Ooh, Durgan Steel. Cool. And the Dragon's Horde. Oh yeah, this is what I wanted. So I wanted to come here before I went into Durgan's Battery, because like I said, that's probably the largest area in the expansion. And I want to go there with as many items as I can. When I say as many items, I mean as many unique items that I want to enjoy throughout the game. So what do we get? We get Rionis' Vambraces. 5% of misses are converted to gray. Only 5%? 3D R by... Ooh! 3D R bypass. That's good. Especially for the grieving mother with the blunderbuss. After Riona established a reputation as a fighter, she began joining adventuring expeditions. For years, she was one of the most sought-after warriors in the Eastern Reach. That changed after an expedition to the White March. She traveled with a team of historians and treasure hunters intent on breaching Durgan's Battery. Yet their guide fell ill, and they became hopelessly lost in the blizzard. The snows continued for days, and their provisions dwindled. While the rest of the party camped in a lee of a cliff, Riona was sent to scout a way ahead. She wandered into the storm, barely able to see the hand in front of her face. After hours of trudging through the snow, Riona stumbled into a cave. Yet, instead of shelter, she found a young alpine dragon. The beast was too lean, and its eyes burned with hunger when it looked at Riona. Yet, she promised it a larger meal if only it would spare her. She led it to the hollow where the rest of her companions waited, and as the dragon turned on them, she fled. She lost the van braces in the snow. What a bitch. That's a horrible person. But I think these are awesome bracers for the grieving mother. We also have Black Sanctuary. It's a small shield that's exceptional. It grants withdraw, which is always useful, and also grants warding seal. These are two per... That's actually kind of cool. It's per encounter. You start dealing AoE shock damage. Nice. I think this would be for somebody in melee, not really for somebody, you know, in the back line. But it is a cool shield. Though its maker's mark can be traced to an otherwise unremarkable smithy in Dawning, this shield earned its fame within the keeping of Polder Grint, a young Adiran lord whose fondness for dueling became the inspiration for many anti-Adir folk songs and plays in the time during and after the War of Defiance. Grint cultivated a reputation as a relentless and unbeatable foe, for whenever the duel seemed to be going poorly, he would raise his black shield and resume the fight with renewed vigor. Grint employed the shield to great effect for several years, until he finally found himself severely outmatched by a more experienced rival. Mistakenly believing that the shield could preserve him even at the precipice of death, Grint fled the field, only to bleed out on the bank of the Iskian River. This is a very cool shield. I really like it. If you could have a fighter with shield bash, I know this is more of a Dungeons & Dragons thing, man, this would be awesome. And finally, we have Sabra Marie. It's a war bow. It grants confuse on critical hit. Oh. Plus 0.5 to crit damage multiplier. Oh my lord. Sabra Marie was owned by an archer from the Velen Republics who fought for their wooden independence. When the War of Defiance began, many from the newly independent republics took up the cause and joined the battle to the north. The Velen had a longer and more melodious name for his bow, but Sabra Marie quickly became the local bastardization. No recorded histories explain where he got the bow, but plenty attest to its usefulness against larger forces. Quick, powerful shots fired from cover scattered and confused many Adiran units throughout the war. Dude, I'm kinda torn. I didn't even remember this was a weapon in the game. Plus 0.5 to crit damage multiplier? Oh my lord, man. It's kind of a shame that this one is already superb. And the range is long. Oh my god, this is so good. It deals less damage, though. It deals less damage, it confuses instead of critting, and critting is better. But, oh man, this... I'm sweating. Okay, I'm gonna keep Bordesane on me. But in case I find myself against, like, a very large... Like, the next dragon... I don't know, I might use this. I'm really curious as to how much damage this can deal. Okay, as for the Grieving Mother, she has a plus 2 to Might and plus 1 to Constitution. I think I'm just gonna trade it in for the DR bypass. Oh, and she already has Constitution from somewhere else, apparently. Oh, she has the girdle. So the only thing she lost was 2 points of Might, which doesn't even affect... Well, it affects the minimum damage by 1. It's not a problem. Okay, Cool.
Hey.
Very cool. I kind of wish he dropped some kind of ingredient to, you know, level up or enchant my weapons further. Like to superb or something like that, but sadly he does not. I believe this was everything in the cave.
Flame and sound.
Yes, it was. Man, that bow. That bow. Confuse on crit. Plus 50% damage on crit. Oh. Oh, my lord. Oh, my lord. Let me check something, by the way. So, Aloth. Highest single target damage, 232. Oh, come on. Really? It's still him. Don't I have my highest damage? Oh, personal, sorry. 218, okay. Sad, I'm very sad. Oh well, regardless. So let's go to Durgan's battery. I want to at least enter the fortress in this episode. It does take a long time, a long portion of the episode when there's a dragon fight, but I mean, there's preparation. I like to talk about the fight, so it does last a little bit. But now we can go into Durgan's battery with our new items and be happy with the fight we just had. Okay, so let's go over there. Now we know the cantec, which should allow us entry. Ah, man. I'm still thinking about that bow. I am still thinking about that bow. And, you know...
Yes.
Man, it's superb. I mean, I lose 4 accuracy. And I go down to 23 to 36 from 25 to 39. I'm gonna try it out, just to see. Okay. Hammers of Durgan ring loud, may the anvil's deep music resound. Walls of battery safeguard our works from Marauder and Wilder alike. Abaddon's faithful travail by the forge and the fires that brighten the ore. I don't actually remember the order, so let's just check this out. Hammers, walls, and Abaddon. Okay. Hammers on... Okay. So the same order. Distantly, you hear the melodic chime of metal on metal and the low chorus of a work song. Oh. I don't know. Wait. I have a little fragment in the Leaden Key. Hammers of Durgan ring loud, may the anvil's deep music resound. Walls of the battery safeguard our works from Marauder and Wilder alike. Abaddon's faithful travail by the forge and the fire that brighten the ore. I don't know. Right. I'm gonna use it there to do this, maybe. I don't think it makes a difference. Okay, so ring loud, so maybe it's striking. Strike the anvil relief. As you do, a single ringing tone whistles through the air. Your hand buzzes and vibrates like struck metal. When you look back at the relief, the panels on either side of the wall and anvil have come alive. Ogres and warriors of all races gather for battle, their shapes and silhouettes formed by flaring, whorled heat patterns. The tiny figures move and dance, animated by the flicker and blaze of an unseen fire. So it's the walls. Walls of the battery safeguard our works from Marauder and Wilder alike. You hear the heavy thud of some kind of mechanism loosening behind the plague. I'm going to say... Push the crenellated wall relief? Oh! Nice! It slides easily with the slightest pressure from your fingers. You guide it up and over the anvil relief, where it clicks into place. Beneath it is a deep cavity. It's shaped like a dragon's gaping jaws. Oh god, is it gonna breathe fire if I fail this? Abaddon's faithful travail by the forge and the fires that brighten the ore. Warm air gusts from the open mouth, tingling your cold, numbed face. Examine the mouth more closely? The heat billowing from the mouth prevents you from getting too close, but the rim of the cavity and the tiny teeth surrounding it are blackened with soot. You accidentally inhale some of the vapor. It's odorless, but it leaves you lightheaded. God damn it. You also notice that the dragon's tongue is a fire striker. It's hinged and attached to a chunk of flint. Ah. Use your torch to light a fire in the mouth. Man, this is awesome. I love these images. Fire catches the warm vapor with a billowing whoosh. The dragon's eyes are alight and flames lick at the edges of its mouth. A few seconds later, the panel is sliding away from you as the two enormous doors swing open into a grand hall. Awesome. This is awesome. I love it. I really love it. So we were left lightheaded, but it doesn't actually do anything. Okay. Let's go in. Man, I don't remember how this starts, but I'm very excited about this area. You sense the presence of one of the other pieces of Geralt's helm nearby. Oh, cool. Okay, so wait, let's just wait for this to finish. Ah, so we finished Durgan's battery. I opened the door to Durgan's battery. I can finally search it for the White Forge and any other mysteries within. The White Forge. I've entered Durgan's battery. The White Forge should be on the bottom floor. The ground floor of Durgan's battery seems to have been deserted long ago. It's not clear where the dwarves went, but they left a mess in their wake. So, we have to be somewhat careful because I don't have some of my powerful spells right here. Durgan still has most of his, but not Aeloth. Maybe I spammed this a little bit too much. We're gonna go in stealth.
Of course. It feels even colder in here. Something isn't right.
Okay, so my journal was just updated? No. Something doesn't feel right, and we're about at time for the episode, so I'm gonna leave a little bit of a cliffhanger here. I am gonna finish the episode here, just as we were about to explore the Great Hall, the first floor of Durgan's battery, for the next one. So, as always, my friends, thank you so much for being here with me in the channel, watching some Pillars of Eternity. I hope you guys enjoyed the Alpine Dragon fight. I wasn't really sure when I was gonna do that fight, but it just felt right before coming here, so I hope you guys liked it. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave a comment below. If you are enjoying the content, consider subscribing for more. There are videos coming out every single day, and it's also a free and easy way to support the channel. And I hope to see you all in the next one. Until then, stay safe, everyone.